Very common question that comes up with Adobe programs is, hey, I've just rented Adobe Premiere and I want to install Encore, but I can't find it. There is no Encore CC and it's not popping up on my list. Where do you get to it? Actually, it's pretty simple when you know how. Open up your Creative Cloud application, go to Apps, and as you can see here, I've got all the list of things that I have installed, but what I want to do is put on Encore. Now, the last version of Encore is the CS6 version. There isn't a CC version, so it's not listed in all the possible apps that you can shove on there. And for a start, to get Encore CS6, you have to install Premiere CS6. But I can't see Premiere CS6 there either. You can see a heading that says previous versions, so you'd think I will click on that and it will show me the previous versions, but it doesn't. The way you get at it is you go down to Find Additional Apps, click on where it says All Apps, and then say View Previous Versions. And now your list changes and you can get to all of the versions of all these Adobe applications all the way back to CS6. So for example, for Premiere, I'll just go to Install here and I'll choose which one I want to put in. So if I want to put CS6 in, I'll click on that and it'll go ahead and install it. You can do the same for any of the other applications, Photoshop, Illustrator. There's even things like Fireworks, which is no longer available. You could put Fireworks on there if you wanted to. Once it's installed, then you can go to the previous versions heading and there you can see, oh, it's installed. This is also where it will pop up and tell you if there's any updates available. And obviously you can just run the program from there or run it from the icon that's in the start menu. And of course I just started Premiere, but if I pop into my start menu and just start typing the word Encore, there you can see I've got Adobe Encore CS6 because that got installed when I put in Premiere CS6. Of course, the way these things actually get installed, you normally put on the Creative Cloud version and then you put CS6 on afterwards, which we do a lot and I've never had any problems with. The only issue I do get is if you go to Windows Explorer and you double click on a Premiere project, it tends to try and open it in CS6, which is a bit of a bummer if you made it in Creative Cloud version, because it will then complain that it can't open it. So I find that because I put CS6 on there, I can't open projects by double clicking on them in Explorer, but I can open them just by starting Premiere and choosing it that way. But that's it. That's how you'll get previous versions on there. Very common question that comes up because, well, simple things like there is a heading that says previous versions. But that's not how you get to the previous versions. You get to the previous versions down here.